What's up, Modded Prats? It's Spiritual God here, and today this is my first attempt at creating a universe. This universe has a similarity but has difference to My Hero Academia. So the main character is Izuku Midoriya. In the canon, he didn't have a quirk, but in this universe he does have, and I'll get to it in a little bit. If you like this video, then don't forget to give your power to me, since I can make more universes by making your power. You can give your power by leaving a like, commenting on what you want, as well as subscribing. So let's watch the universe together. Izuku Midoriya was a 3-year-old kid roaming around the park with his childhood friends Katsuki Bakugo. They both played tag while Izuku was trying to catch Bakugo. "Come on, Izuku, try to catch me," says Bakugo. "I'm trying, Kachan," says Izuku. Kachan is actually Bakugo's nickname. While Izuku is trying to catch Kachan, he scratches a little. Kachan stops and says, "Are you okay, Izuku?" Izuku saying, "I'm okay." Then, before completing his sentence, he falls down to the ground and starts trembling. His mom, Inko Midoriya, and Bakugo's mother, Mitsuki Bakugo, were both sitting in the public park and talking. And when Kachan is confused and goes near Izuku, a bright light starts getting the attention of both the mothers. Inko says, "What's happening? Why is the ground shaking over the bed?" Mitsuki replies, no, but there might be bright light where Izuku and Kasuki is." Inko sees that and starts going towards the same. Mitsuki does the same, but before they could go away, a light goes upward like it was growing in height, creating a wind pressure, both the women and the citizens, making them fall. "Just what is that?" says Inko while getting up. "Maybe someone activated the quirk," replying Mitsuki doing the same. After a moment, the light fades away, revealing a huge person about 15 meters high. "Oh my god! Is that a villain attack? Maybe we should call the pro heroes," says another. Some people take out their phones and start calling the pros and the police.
"Izuku, where are you? Katsuki, are you safe?"
Both of them respond, but no response comes and they start worrying. But Inko hears a slight voice from above, and when she checks, seeing a small figure on the shoulders of the giant person, she asks Mitsuki,
"Is that Katsuki? Is that Katsuki?"
"Wait."
"It is. What is he doing there and with Izuku? And where is Izuku?"
They both remain silent for a moment until the giant person tries to move but trips. Inko says,
"Oh god, please don't fall. Please don't fall. My son's life is in your hands,"
Mitsuki shouts to the giant person. Before he could fall, he uses his back weight to go behind and stand, which he successfully does. Mitsuki and Inko open their eyes, seeing the giant person standing still. They calm down for a moment, and then Mitsuki says,
"Maybe that is Izuku?"
Inko says,
"That's not possible. His father nor I don't have a quirk like that. But you might be right."
Inko shouts,
"Hey big guy, if you're Izuku Midoriya, then shake your hand."
A few moments passes, but nothing happens. Izuku says that the big man is not her son, but then the hand of the giant person, as well as both his hands, starts shaking ridiculously. Inko shouts,
"Put down Bakugo and do it slowly if you are my Izuku."
Again, suspecting that giant person can't be his son. After a moment, his arms move to his shoulder. Mitsuki starts worrying a little bit, but Inko calms her down. The hand comes down, nearly. When the hand comes down and opens, it releases Katsuki, smiling in joy. Mitsuki quickly holds of Kachan, taking it from giant person. Kachan shouts on the top of his lungs,
"Izuku, now calmly sit down."
The giant person sits down calmly, since he didn't want to make a small earthquake. Kachan gets off his mother's grip and runs to the giant person, hugging his index finger of the leg, which is too big for Kachan. The puller pros away, and at the exact moment, the giant person falls back. But before hitting the ground, he uses his hand uses hand and tears off the back of his neck, in which Izu was. Then he hits his head behind a rock, crushing into pieces. The pro sees this and helps Inko and Mitsuki take the child to hospital. After some hours, Izuko wakes up seeing the Inko and his left hand catching the left side with Mitsuki also there. Izuko said,
"Where am I?"
Inko seeing Izuko wake up, but before she could say anything, the doctor comes and says, "Congrats, Mr. Mizuya. His son has a quirk now."
Inko says, "What kind of quirk, doctor?"
Doctor says, "It's called Titanification. We haven't managed to learn anything yet, but this quirk's allowing him to go into 15 meter tall at least, and increases speed, strength, and other defenses." Izuko gets excited and asks,
Can I become a hero with this quirk, doctor?"
This surprised everyone in the room. Doctor says, "That depends on how you use a quirk, but be careful about it because it is quite a serious quirk." Inko's about to say something, but Izuko interrupts and says, I'm gonna use this quirk and become the number one hero like All Might." Inko says, because she didn't want her son to use his quirk. But hero means that he had to use a quirk literally every day. Inko sees the determination in Izuko's eyes. "That's it. I managed to use my power to create this much only. But as I said, I need your power models. If you liked it, then do a godly smash on the like button as well as the subscribe button. Ta-ta."